Salam Lok and welcome to the narrative. So we are here in Melkadida, which is near Dolwado, and Dolwado is on the border of Somalia and Ethiopia. So as you can see from the surroundings, it's a bit of a dry land, a desert type area. It's dry, it's hot, okay, and it's a bit dusty at times, which is different from Addis Ababa, the capital city of Ethiopia, where we were for the last 4 days. Okay, so it was cold over there, so it's hot here. So we have a change in ambient temperatures, as well as there has been this constant wind, you know, right from morning till night. So the place, though it's hot, you have cool winds blowing, so it's pretty nice. So today is the fourth day that I've been here, so I decided let's review the last 3 days as it's gone by. So I came here on Monday. So the only way to get from Addis Ababa to Melkadida is by an aircraft, as you would have already seen in the introduction. So it's a small aircraft where there's place for only 12 passengers and the pilot. The other way, if you want to walk, it's an 9 days journey, okay, with rest of course. So because it's around 916 kilometers from Addis Ababa, so it's basically 8 days. Google shows you 8 days, but you need to take some rest on the way, so it will come to around 9 to 10 days. Next, if you come by car, okay, or by road, it's around 16.5 hours. So that's a bit of a long journey. So the fastest way is by the aircraft, which is 2.5 hours. So as I said, so on the first day I arrived here at around 10 o'clock. So on that day, that was Monday morning, I got up at around 3:30, so just did the final packing and then reached the airport at 4:30, because of course you're in a new place, you don't want to mess up, you want to be on time, because 4:30 was my reporting time. And but the guys for check-in came in at 5:30, so I had to wait there for 1 hour. But you're on the airport, so there's Wi-Fi, you can do a lot of things, so not a problem. And then got my check-in done. Now the problem was, I was given 12 kilos for my luggage, so, and I didn't want to exceed 12, but when I checked on the weighing scale, it was around 14, so I had to drop back a few things, including the shaving set. So over the course of the days, you would see the beard grow as well. So I had to drop many things back at Addis Ababa. So I did not carry many things with me, so because I was not sure what would be the penalty if I had to exceed the 12 kilo weight limit. So once the checking in was done, okay, I was relieved. Then went to the gate, and there I had to wait for another hour because the flight was delayed, of course. And we were supposed to leave Addis Ababa at 6:30, but we only left the place at around 7:30 or 7:40. So 2.5 hour flight, reached here at around 10. Once I reached here, of course, so I had some time to relax in the morning. Then we had lunch, and after lunch I went around one of the campsites. So the JRS operation in Dolwado has two basic campsites. One is Melkadida and the other one is Kobe. So I went to the Melkadida campsite, saw the various departments. So they have the class for plumbing, they have also a class of tailoring, the computer class, as well as the male hairdressing. So these 4 units, and also I saw the community center over there. And then we went to the ARA office because I had to get my permit done. So got my permit, and well, that was the first day. So it was very interesting, a lot of new things to learn, of course. Got to learn about the area as well, was trying to adjust also to the area. And on the second day, we attended the graduation ceremony, as you would have seen in the pics. So the graduation ceremony at the other campsite in Kobe. So it was the adult education program, and so after they finish the 6 months course, they usually have a kind of a graduation ceremony just to encourage them to, you know, participate in further activities. And after that, so that was from morning from 9 till around 12:30, and then in the evening basically I was given my plan how I was supposed to proceed for the next few days. So basically in the mornings I would have to assist the computer teacher in the computer education program, and in the evenings I would basically be teaching the staff the basic computer education. So mornings from 8 to 11:30, and then in the afternoon from 3 to 5, and the rest of the evenings was pretty interesting because of course yesterday also I watched the semi-final, the previous day also the semi-final, very interesting, and of course a bit of mosquitoes around the place, but they seem to be friendly enough, but not friendly enough to give you a good night's sleep. So that was day 2. Day 3, that is today, was basically my first day at the computer education program. So we basically started with Word and went through the basics. So there are two batches. One is from 8 to 9:20, and the second batch starts from 9:30 to 11. And so basically different levels of teaching also, because there are some who are very new to computers, some have some knowledge about computers. So again, so that was there, and also then in the evening with the staff, so that was pretty interesting as well. So all that, so tomorrow is going to be another interesting day, because again it's going to be day 2 of the of my experience in the field. So stay tuned for further updates, and feel free, if you have any questions, do write it in the comment section, and basically when I get time I will answer them. Okay, so that's all from day 3 in Melkadida.